to unwind. The best is yet to come, they say. Mindless wandering eyes, I'm needing to unwind. The best is yet to come, they say. With ocean crashing tides, the taste of your skin, the way you looked at midnight rings and on your way.
Hi there. This is the senior scene today, and your host is Bernadette Jones. Let me tell you, you are going to have a wonderful show today. We're going to talk about fathers. You know, that day isn't long off, and we do have to think what we're going to do. So stay tuned. We'll be right back. Today's presentation is on fathers. Let me give you some reminiscent of my father. I'll use him first. Unfortunately, or fortunately, I guess it depends on the way you look at it. I never really had much association with my father because at an early age, my father contracted tuberculosis. Now, you know how old I am, so you know this was a long time ago. In those days, tuberculosis was really a stunning disease as far as knocking medical personnel and families, knocked them aloof, because at that time, there wasn't much cure for tuberculosis. So when my father was diagnosed with that, the ultimate was to be bundled up and sent to a sanitarium. And you know, through history, sanitarium has not been a pretty word. Well, anyway, I do remember just some things about my father, that he was a small man, handsome, and my daddy. But I never really got to know him because I must have been about 5 years old when he was sent to, as mentioned, the Herman Kiefer Hospital in Detroit, Michigan. But I still have another pleasant memory. We used to go visit him, and of course that was thrilling at my age to get on a train and go anywhere. So I do remember the trips going to Detroit to visit my father and meeting some other members of the family, and it wasn't all bad. Many of you, I'm sure, experienced the same thing. A foster father, or your parent gets married again and you get a new father. So I'm sure out there are many, many memories about the particular dad that came into your life. I have a great treat for you. We're going to show a clip of a great American father and his daughter. Keep watching.
Won't you play a simple melody?
Play a melody
like my mother sang to me.
Like my mother sang to me, my honey.
One with good old fashioned harmony.
One with harmony.
Play a simple melody.
Thank you.
You know, mothers are really applauded more than fathers. I don't know what the reason, but then mother, she's the one that's in the kitchen cooking and doing the things, and father is out there working. And of course, I assume that most of us, when we were young, the fact that father was out there working and we didn't get to see that much of him, and when he came home, he was tired and wanted to eat. Maybe that's why the comedians, they have used fathers as a joke for many years. And yet, like I say, we know fathers that are no joke. Let me give you an example of one that I laughed when I heard it. This little girl woke up in the middle of the night, and she goes to her mother and she says, "Ma, please tell me a story." And Ma looks at her and says, "Shh, child, you wait till your father gets home, and he'll tell us both a story." I thought that was kind of a idea where the jokesters always have something to say about dads. The other thing is that in today's world, fathers are really coming back into their own. I'll never forget when I had my first child, who is now near 40. In those days, it was so different. Well, in my particular instance, it was so different. Because now fathers are there when they come out. Well, in my day, the father's function was to help you get your suitcase ready and have the car gassed and be standing on the sidelines when you said, "Baby, it's time." He would get you to the car, grab up your suitcase, take you to the hospital, drop you almost off the doorstep, and then he would come back later to see his pride and joy. Well, believe me, it is so different nowadays. Fathers are in every phase of motherhood, and as I say, they're right there when the baby comes out. Now, of course, times have changed, the hospitals have changed. They don't allow, when I was having children, that much freedom in the hospital. But nowadays, mothers get the their daddies get the photographs and all angles of the first day. And so I tell you, fathers are to be applauded. And today, fathers definitely are taking their place in the family unit. I, for one, am very happy about that because our youth need a father figure. So stay tuned. We'll be right back. We're not finished with fathers yet. So when we come back, we're going to have a happier note on fathers.
Hey, you know, some months ago, Kenny Rogers and his friends put on a show at the MGM Grand in Las Vegas, celebrating 50 years that Kenny Rogers has been in business. Can you imagine? I know he said he didn't know where he was going to be at the end of the next 50 years, but he was keeping the MGM Grand on the list. He's had a lot of good songs in the 50 years he's been in. Spirit burns a stair, a window at the darkness, till warm over the mist, and he began to speak. He said, "Son, I made a life. Had reading people's faces, knowing what the cards were, by the way they held their eyes. So if you don't mind my saying, I can see your other faces. For a taste of your whiskey, I'll give you some of it, but you've got no wind to hold. No wind to hold. What to keep, 'cause every hand is a winner, Every hand's a loser, and the best you can hope for is to die a good kid. You've got to know when to hold them. Know when to hold them. Know when to back away. Know when to run. You never ask your mind. What is that in that table there?
To continue about fathers, we're going to have the more pleasant note about fathers, and we have some photographs to show you about fathers who are right into the thick of things. And of course, the biggest item for Father's Day is the gift. I know you're sick of ties. I know you're sick of maybe tools, but we're going to take you shopping. So stay tuned, and we will be right back.
For he's a jolly good fellow, which nobody can deny. For he's a jolly good fellow, which nobody can deny. For he's a jolly good fellow, which nobody can deny.
We have come back from our tour of places to get gifts for Dad. Now, of course, all of this depends on your pocketbook, I'm telling you. But if you're more than one sibling, then you can all kind of put your money together to get Dad a big gift. Or dads like to eat. How about taking Dad out to a restaurant, getting all the family and the other brothers and sisters, aunts and uncles, and take him out to some fabulous restaurant and let him get whatever he wants on the menu. And if your money don't cover it, you order the hamburger. But let him get the big T-bone steak. How about it? All right now, I'm depending on you. You'll be seeing some restaurants that perhaps you could take Dad to. wonderful. It made me hungry. So to end our ideas of pro and con on fathers, they are a necessary evil. First thing, we need a father to have the siblings. And so even though your heart may not be in it, or you have some problems with your dad, or you don't know where dad is, or whatever, when that day comes, make an effort to look him up and do something nice. Because fathers are important, and many of them really don't know how you feel about them. And we've become such a world of people who seem to have forgotten that, well, what love is. And you know, you think because maybe you call him once on the phone every now and then that that's love. But sometimes the father doesn't receive that. And so all of you out there who has a father who is loving and caring and makes you feel good, God bless you. And all of those out there that you don't think your father has some of the attributes you want, let me give you a clue. Check yourself. Are you father material? And then take pity or think differently about your father. And for all of you out there, from the senior scene, whatever the circumstances, whoever he is, I wish him a very happy, happy Father's Day. Thank you. Well, this is it, folks, for today. I do hope you enjoy our presentation for Father's Day. Remember to take care of your father by seeing that he gets proper health care. You know how men are. They're big, macho, but baby, their bodies get the same thing as other folks. Take care of your dad. See you later.
The Tuskegee Airmen were an all-black fighter squadron, the 332nd Fighter Group, actually, who did bomber escort, which meant they put their life in jeopardy to make sure that the B-52 bombers got home safe.
It offered me the opportunity to be a pilot. You know, I like to look back. When I was a young man, I looked back and I thought about the Buffalo soldiers, and I tried to amplify the things that they had done. And hopefully that young persons that are coming behind now will try to amplify the things that I've accomplished.
Well, it's important for the younger generation to know, first of all, the history of the past, but mainly that in order to overcome obstacles, you have to be excellent. The Tuskegee Airmen stands for excellence. We were people who were in college, we were leaders of our group, we were athletes, we were valedictorians.
And it's men like this that helped to provide the freedoms that we enjoy and paved the way for specifically African-American men to do their part in the war effort, not just World War II, but all the major war efforts that America has been involved in. And I just have the opportunity now and to say thank you.
You're welcome.
You for your service, sir. And your devotion to your country. And
for 92 years, and I hope 92 more.
92 years, that's what I'm saying.
He's young, looks good, too strong. Hurt my hand, that's a whole nother conversation.
It's an honor to be a part of this experience and this journey. To be able to stand and talk to living history is really amazing.
And I'm a little overwhelmed because the president's about to watch our movie.
He recognizes the heritage that we bring to invite us here and to see this wonderful movie, this exciting movie. It is really top notch. You will be sitting in your seat wondering what's going to happen next. You'll enjoy it.
Hope you enjoy yourselves. We're going to be bringing in popcorn for...
For he's a jolly good fellow, which nobody can deny. For he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, which nobody can deny. Which nobody can deny, which nobody can deny. For he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, which nobody can deny. For he's a jolly good fellow, which nobody can deny. For he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, which nobody can deny. Which nobody can deny, which nobody can deny. For he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, which nobody. For he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, which nobody can deny. For he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, which nobody can deny. Which nobody can deny, which nobody can deny. For he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow. jolly good fellow. For he's a jolly good fellow, we'll show what he can deny.
Number 10, Verna Day Jones.
Real proud. I'm gonna die. Jump. Phenomenal.